In this video, we will see the regular expressions in Java. Regular expressions are used to search particular pattern in a given string. Now, when I am using regular expressions, I need to import java.util.regex. There are three classes. One is pattern class, then matcher class is there, and there is one more class, pattern syntax exception. So, pattern class is a compiled object version of the pattern that I am searching. Matcher class is an engine which will search the expression into the given string, and the last class, pattern syntax exception, it will raise an exception if there is a syntax mistake in the string that you are searching. In next slide, there is a list of symbols which are used as a meta character syntax in regular expression. Like first symbol indicates the beginning of the line, dollar indicates the end of the line, dot indicates any single character, three dots in subscripts indicates one or more characters. So there are many symbols available. Into the next slide, you can see that RE plus, regular expression plus, indicates the one or more occurrences of the previous matching thing. Then RE, regular expression question mark, indicates 0 or 1 occurrence of the previous expression. Then RE inside angular bracket n, regular expression n, indicates exactly n number of occurrences of the previous expression, and so on. So here are few more characters. You can go through the slide to understand the characters used by the regular expressions. Now after that, we will see one example which will tell us how to implement a code using regular expressions in Java. Here is the code. For example, in main method there are two strings. First string is the string I am searching in, and second string is pattern that I want to search. So I have created pattern object first. After that, I have created matcher object, and after that I am finding the pattern into the input string. Now when I find a pattern, here something is written: group of 0, group of 1, group of 2. So what that group is, if you see this pattern, then it will have 4 groups. For this particular pattern, you will be having 4 groups. Which are the 4 groups? The first group will be the whole pattern. The second group will be the set of characters which are in the first parenthesis. Then next group will be set of character in the second parenthesis, and next group will be again set of characters in the third parenthesis. So you will be having 4 groups, and they will start from 0 to 3. They will vary from 0 to 3. So this m dot group of 0, that means I am searching for the whole pattern into the input string. So that the meaning of that will be, I am searching for any number of characters which are followed by one or more digits, which are followed by any number of characters. So this will return me the whole string. Then m dot group of 1. So group of 1 means dot star only. So I am searching for any number of characters in the input string. So that will also return me the whole string. And second group I am printing, m dot group of 2. So that is nothing but I am searching for backslash backslash d plus pattern. So basically you are searching for a string which is followed by one or more digits. So as per my understanding, this will return the string up till value qt 300. So we will check the output and we will confirm it. So let's implement the program practically.
So here we are using regular expressions. Input string is this one, then pattern is this, and I am creating first pattern object, then matcher object, and I am searching the string for particular pattern. So I am printing group of 0, group of 1, group of 2, and group of 3. So group 0 is whole string, that means any number of characters followed by one or more digits followed by any number of characters. So this will print whole string into the output. So first output is whole input string, you will see that. Then next, group of 1. Group of 1 is dot star, so it is any number of characters, but when second group is evaluated, it will take care that remaining regular expression is not violated. So it will print the string up till 300, so that one digit is left for this D. After that, group of 2 is printed, which is nothing but this is group 2. So it is one or more digit. Now in the last output, I got the value up till 300. So 10 is remaining that I will get. One or more digits means only 10 is remaining that is fetched by this particular group. And last group is again dot star, that means any number of characters. So up till last 0, the string has been searched. So remaining value, which is a sequence of any characters, will be printed into the output of group of 3. So this was about the regular expressions.